In this video, we are going to see an assignment problem by Hungarian method with an application of diagonal selection. So diagonal selection is applicable only when there is more than one zero in the matrix. Okay, see, I have already uploaded a separate video for assignment problem. There I have explained algorithm for simple problem only. So here we are going to see the same algorithm in a different scenario. See, in order to solve the assignment problem, okay, it has certain procedures. The first one is phase 1 and the second one phase 2. Now let us see the algorithm along with the problem. Look at the problem. Solve the following assignment problem using Hungarian method. The matrix entries represent the processing time in hours. Here we have 4 operators and 4 jobs. These are the elements represent processing times in hours. By using the Hungarian method, we are going to allocate the different jobs to different operator. Okay, by using the Hungarian method. Okay, so the main objective of this method is to minimize the processing time by allocating different jobs to different operator. Okay, see the algorithm. These are the algorithms. The first one is phase 1, that is row reduction and column reduction, and phase 2 is optimization of the problem. Okay, now let us see the first phase, that is row reduction and column reduction. See, row reduction means from each and every row find the least value. Okay, so first thing, identification of least value, that is row minimum. From each and every row, identify the least value and subtract that least element from each and every other element. Okay, by this way, you will be getting the new matrix. That is, after row reduction, you will be getting new matrix. The first one is row minimum. In the first row, which one is least value? 2. In the second row, again 2 is the least value. In the third row, 4 is the minimum value. In the fourth row, 5 is the minimum value. So in the first row, 2. Second row again, 2. Third row, 4. Fourth row, 5. Okay, these are the row minimum. Now, subtract these values from all other elements. You will be getting new matrix. Okay, for the first row, 5 minus 2, 3 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 8 minus 2. You will be getting 3, 1, 0, 6. Look at the second row. The second row minimum value is 2. No, 7 minus 2, 9 minus 2, 2 minus 2, 6 minus 2. You will be getting 5, 7, 0 and 4. Look at the third row. The least value is 4. No, 6 minus 4, 4 minus 4, 5 minus 4, 7 minus 4. You will be getting 2, 0, 1, 3. Look at the last row. The least value is 5. So 5 minus 5, 7 minus 5, 7 minus 5 and 8 minus 5. You will be getting 0, 2, 2 and 3. This is the new matrix after row reduction. Now you have to find out the column minimum. After row reduction, okay, from this matrix, you need to find out the column minimum in order to do the column reduction. Look at the first column. The least value is, that is column minimum. The least value is 0. In the second column, the least value is 0. In the third column, again 0. In the fourth column, 3 is the minimum value. After finding the column minimum, now subtract these values from each and every element of each and every column. So 3 minus 0, you will be getting the same value, 3. 5 minus 0, again 5. 2 minus 0, 2. 0 minus 0, 0. Okay. If you get 0 as a row minimum or column minimum, then you will be getting the same value in the new matrix. For the first column, the new values are 3, 5, 2 and 0. Okay. In the second column, the minimum value is 0. So you will be getting the same value as it is. 1, 7, 0 and 2. In the third column also, you will be getting the same value. 0, 0, 1 and 2. In the last column, the least value is 3. No. So 6 minus 3, 4 minus 3, 3 minus 3, again 3 minus 3. You will be getting 3, 1, 0, 0. Okay, this is the new matrix after row and column reduction. Okay, the first phase is over. Look at the procedure. So far we have done phase 1, that is row reduction and column reduction is over. After completing the first phase, now we need to go for the second phase. The second phase is optimization of the problem. In the second phase, it has 3 steps. The first step is after row reduction, column reduction, you will be getting the new matrix. No, from the new matrix, you have to draw a minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros of the matrix. Okay, in order to perform the first step, it has 2 procedures. The first one is row scanning and the second one column scanning. Row scanning means, okay, start from the first row and check whether you have got only 1 0. If you find only 1 0, mark square around that zero, okay, and draw a vertical line passing through that zero. Okay, if you find more than 1 0 or no zero in the first row, just skip that row and go to second row. Apply the same procedure till the last row. Okay, after row scanning, check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. If yes, go to next step. If no, there you need to apply column scanning. Column scanning means the same procedure but column wise. Okay, look at the first column. Check whether you have got only 1 0. If you find only 1 0, just put 1 square around that zero and draw horizontal line passing through that zero. If you find more than 1 0 or no zero, just skip that column and go to next column. Okay, apply the same procedure till the last column. After row scanning and column scanning, now you have to check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. If yes, go to next step. Okay, still if you find any single zero, either in column or row, there you need to do row scanning and column scanning again and again to cover that zero with lines. Okay, if you find more than 1 0, either in column or row, there you need to apply diagonal selection. Again, I explain, after row scanning and column scanning, check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. If yes, go to next step. Okay, if you find any zero, after row scanning and column scanning, still if you find any single zero, either in column or row, then you need to do row scanning and column scanning again and again to cover that zero with lines. Okay, if you find more than 1 0, either in column or row, okay, there you need to apply diagonal selection. See, diagonal selection means select a zeros which is diagonally opposite with each other. For example, if you select 1 0 in a first row, you need to select other zero that should be exactly opposite for the selected zero. Okay, so it can be in the second row or any row, but the condition is it should be diagonally opposite. So let me explain this point along with the problem. Look at the problem. This is the new matrix after row reduction and column reduction. See, the first phase is over. Now we are in second phase, that is optimization of the problem. Okay, the first step is, okay, you have to draw a minimum line to cover all the zeros. Okay, in order to perform the first step, okay, it has 2 procedures. The first one is row scanning. Row scanning means, see the first row, check whether you have only 1 0. If you find only 1 0, mark square around that zero and draw a vertical line passing through this zero. Okay, this is called row scanning. If you find 2 0s or no zeros, just skip the first row and go to the second row. But here we have got only 1 0, so we have marked square and we have drawn vertical line passing through this 0. Okay, after completing the first row, go to the second row, do the same thing. Please check whether there is any single 0. No, one 0 is there, that 0 is already deleted. Now, no zeros are available. So, skip this row, go to the next row. Okay, in the next row, check whether you have got only one 0. See here, we have two zeros. So, skip this row, go to the next row. Again, here also we have got two zeros. So, skip this row also. So, this is called as row scanning. After completing row scanning, just check whether all the zeros are covered with line. If yes, go to step 2. If no, go for column scanning. So far we have done only row scanning, but still we have some zeros without line. So now you have to go for column scanning. Column scanning means the same thing. Look at the first column. Okay, check whether you have only one 0. If you find only one 0, mark square around that 0 and draw a horizontal line passing through this 0. Okay, if you find no 0 or if you find more than one 0, just skip that column and go to second column. Okay, here we have got only one 0, so we have marked square and we have drawn horizontal line. Now go to second column, check whether you have got only one 0. Yes, we have got only one 0, so mark square around this 0 and draw a horizontal line passing through this 0. Okay, now go to the third column. Third column already deleted. Now go to last column. No zeros are there. Okay, now you have done row scanning and column scanning. So after completing row scanning and column scanning, check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. Yes, here we have covered all the zeros. If you find any zero without line, then you have to perform row scanning and column scanning again and again as much as possible. Okay, now but here we have covered all the zeros with line. Now you have to go to next step. We have done step 1, that is we have drawn minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros. Okay, for this we have done row scanning and column scanning and we have verified that all the zeros are covered with line. Okay, so if yes, go to next step. If no, diagonal selection. Okay, we have verified that all the zeros are covered with line. Now you can go to next step. The next step is, now you have to check the number of squares marked is equal to number of rows. Look at the matrix. How many zeros are selected? Here we have only 1, 2 and 3. Here we have 3 squares. Okay, but how many rows are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 rows. So, see, here we have 3 squares. We have marked 3 squares. Okay, and we have 4 rows. So, this is not equal. Now, see the procedure. Okay, step 2 is, number of squares marked must be equal to number of rows. If yes, treat the solution as marked by the squares as the optimal solution. Okay, if you satisfy this rule, okay, this solution will be optimum solution. Okay, now you can stop the procedure. If no, go to step 3. Okay, so according to this problem, we didn't satisfy this rule because the number of square marked is 3, but the number of row is 4. So this is not equal. So you have to go to the next step. The next step is, step 3 is, identify the minimum value of the undeleted cell values. Okay, look at the matrix and identify the least value in the matrix which is not deleted. Okay, so among the undeleted values, select least one. Okay, and after identifying the least value, then you have to follow this procedure. The first one is copy and second one addition and the third one subtraction. Let me explain this step along with the problem. Step 3 is, identify the minimum value, okay, from the undeleted values. Here 3, 1, 3, 5, 7, 1. These are the undeleted values. So among these values, find out the least value. So which one is least value? 1. So 1 is the least value among undeleted values. So now you have to make a new matrix by following these steps. The first one is copy. Okay, so you have to copy the deleted value as it is. Okay, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2, 0, 2. These are the deleted value. No, so copy as it is. In the new matrix, copy these values as it is. Okay, and the second one is add. You have to add the least value in the intersecting point. So intersecting points means where the horizontal line and vertical line, okay, intersect with each other. Okay, this point and this point, intersecting point. So here you need to add the least value which is already identified. Here we have got 1, no. So 1 plus 1, you will be getting 2 in the new matrix. Here the value is 2. So 2 plus 1, you will be getting 3 in the new matrix. The first step is copy the deleted value as it is. And second one is add the least value along with the intersecting point. And the next one is subtract. So subtract this value from all other undeleted values. Let us see the new matrix. Now the first one is copy the deleted value as it is except the intersecting point. So 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 0. At the intersecting point, add the least value. So 1 plus 1, you'll be getting 2. 1 plus 2, you'll be getting 3. Okay, we have copied all the deleted value except intersecting point. At the intersecting point, we have added the least value. So 2 steps is over. The last one is subtract the least value from all other undeleted values. 3 minus 1, 1 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 5 minus 1, 7 minus 1, 1 minus 1. So you will be getting 2, 4, 0, 6, 2, 0. So this is a new matrix after applying the third step, that is copy, addition, subtraction. Okay, so we have followed the last step. Now we have got the new matrix. See the algorithm. After completing third step, that is, this is the last step. So after completing the last procedure, now you have to go to step 1. Again, we need to repeat or start from step 1. Step 1 is draw a minimum number of lines to cover all the zeros of the matrix. So in order to perform this step, you have to do row scanning and column scanning. Okay, this is a new matrix after the last step. Now you have to do row scanning and column scanning to cover all the zeros. So check whether only one zero in the first row. No, here we have got two zeros. So skip this row and go to next row. Again, in the second row also, we have got two zeros. Skip this row, go to third row. Here also, we have got two zeros. In the last row also, we have got two zeros. So, we could not cover any zeros. Now, we can do column scanning. See the first column. Yes, here we have got only one zero. So, mark square around this zero and draw horizontal line passing through this zero. Now go to the second column. In the second column, we have got two zeros. So skip this column, go to next column. Here also we have got two. In the last column also we have got two zeros. We could not cover all the zeros because here we have got more than one zero in row as well as column. Here you need to apply diagonal selection. I told you, no, after row scanning and column scanning, if you find more than one zero, okay, you have to apply diagonal selection. See the algorithm. After row scanning and column scanning, check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. If yes, go to next step. Okay, if you find any zero after row scanning and column scanning, still if you find any single zero either in column or row, then You need to do row scanning and column scanning again and again to cover that zero with lines. Okay, if you find more than one zero, either in column or row, okay, there you need to apply diagonal selection. See, diagonal selection means select a zeros which is diagonally opposite with each other. For example, if you select one zero in a first row, you need to select other zero that should be exactly opposite for the selected zero. Okay, so it can be in the second row or any row, but the condition is it should be diagonally opposite. So let me explain this point along with the problem. Look at the first row. Here we have got two zeros. No, we can select this one or this one. Okay, which means multiple optimal solution exist. Okay, we have many options. So now let us see the first option. If I select this zero, see, I marked this zero. Okay, in the row scanning, in the first row, I have selected this row so that this column will get cancelled. Okay, so automatically I need to select other zero that should be exactly diagonally opposite with this zero. Okay, which one is diagonally opposite? This one. Okay, or I can select this also, because here we have got two zeros diagonally opposite with this zero. So I can select either this one or this one. So I'm going to select this one. Okay, see, this zero is diagonally opposite. So if I select this zero, in the second row I have selected this, so that this column will get cancelled. Okay, now look at the third row. In the third row, only one zero is available, so no other option. I have to select this zero and draw a vertical line passing through this zero. Now check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. Yes, all the zeros are covered. Now check the condition. What is the condition? See the procedure. We have covered all the zeros with lines. Okay, if S, go to next step. What is the next step? Number of squares marked is equal to number of rows. So this is the condition. Okay, here, how many number of squares marked? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, what is the condition? Number of squares marked is equal to number of rows. So how many rows in the matrix? 1, 2, 3, 4. So see the procedure. Okay, step 2 is, number of squares marked must be equal to number of rows. If yes, treat the solution as marked by the squares as the optimal solution. Okay, if you satisfy this rule, okay, this solution will be optimum solution. Okay, now you can stop the procedure. Number of squares marked is equal to 4. Number of rows, 4. So both are equal. See, treat the solution as marked by the squares as the optimal solution. Okay, this is the optimal solution. Why? Because the condition is satisfied. Okay, now you can assign the job to different operators. Okay, here how many jobs are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 4 jobs. How many operators? 4 operators. A, B, C, D. Now, you have to assign the job to different operators. Okay, so job 1 is assigned to operator B, and job 2 assigned to operator C, and job 3 assigned to operator D, and job 4 assigned to operator A. Now you have to enter the time. Look at the problem. Job 1 assigned to B. So timing is 3 hours. Job 2 assigned to operator C. Duration is 2 hours. Job 3 assigned to D. Duration is 7 hours. And job 4 assigned to operator A, duration is 5 hours. Now get the total. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 plus 7, 12. 12 plus 5, 17. So 17 hours. Okay, this is the optimal solution. Now let us see the other option. Okay, for exam point of view, you can do only one option. For your better understanding, let me show the other possibilities also. So whatever may be the possibilities, the final answer will be remain same. See, now I am going to show the other option. In the previous matrix, I have selected this one. No. So now I am going to select the other option. So I am going to select the second zero. If I select this zero in the first row, I need to select the other zero. The other zero should be diagonally opposite. So options are, this is also diagonally opposite, okay, or I can select this one. This is also diagonally opposite, or I can select this one. So this is also diagonally opposite. So three options are there. So now I'm going to select this one because this is also diagonally opposite. So if I select this zero, okay, this column will get cancelled, and if I select this one, so this column also get cancelled. Okay, the first row is over. Now see the second row. So in the second row, here we have only one zero. So no other option. I have to select this zero and draw a vertical line passing through this zero. Now check whether all the zeros are covered with lines. Yes. Okay, this is a second option. So diagonal selection is applicable where there is multiple optimal solution exist. Okay, this is the second possibilities. So I have done this for your better understanding. For exam point of view, you need not show the other options. You can show only one possibility for the optimal solution. So let us see the answer. So job 1, operator C, and job 2 assigned to operator D, and job 3 assigned to operator B, and job 4 assigned to operator A. Now enter the duration. Look at the problem. Job 1 assigned to C. So duration is 2 hours. 2. Job 2 assigned to D. Duration is 6 hours. Job 3 assigned to B. Duration is 4 hours. And job 4 assigned to A. Duration is 5 hours. Now get the total. 2 plus 6, 8. 8 plus 4, 12. 12 plus 5, 17. So we have got same answer. Whatever may be the option, the final answer will be remain same. Look at the first possibilities. So first job assigned to B, second one C, third one D, and fourth one A. See the second possibility. First job assigned to C, second one D, third one B, and fourth one A. But we have got the same answer. 17 hours and 17 hours. This is the way to solve assignment problem when there is more than 1 0 either in row or column. This is the diagonal selection application. Hope you all understood this concept. Thank you.